Hi children,
in previous class we have learned some concepts related to the trigonometric ratios. Now we are going to learn very important topic, trigonometric identities. Before going to the trigonometric identity, what is meant by an identity? Identity is an equation which is true for all the values of the variables involving in it for which the equation is defined. Let me give an example regarding this. X plus y whole square equals to x square plus y square plus 2xy. Here LHS is equal to RHS for all the values of the x and y. Suppose this is also an identity, 1 by x plus 1 by y whole square equals to 1 by x square plus 1 by y square plus 1 by 2xy. Because of, for x 0, y 0, it is undefined. Such values, no need to substitute. By omitting those values, and for which values of the x and y, this equation is defined. For all those values, is it true or not? It is enough to check out to say the given equation is an identity. Again, let me repeat, what is the definition of the identity, children? Identity is an equation which is true for all the values of the variables in the equation for which the equation is defined. Okay, now come to the trigonometric identity. Sin square a plus cos square a is equal to 1. It is true for all the values of the a in triangle ABC. Angle B is 90 degrees. I am defining sin A as BC by AC, cos A as AB by AC. By the Pythagoras theorem, we have one result, that is AC square is equal to AB square plus BC square. Now throughout this equation, divide with AC square. Then what do you get? 1 is equal to AB by AC. From 1, what is, from 2, what is AB by AC? Cos. Replace AB by AC by cos, whole square is there, that's why cos square A. Plus BC by AC. From 1, what is BC by AC? BC by AC is nothing but the sin A. Therefore, BC by AC whole square is there. Replace BC by AC whole square with sin square A. Finally, what do we get there? Sin square A plus cos square A is equal to 1. This is the first identity in trigonometric identities. Children, let us learn the second trigonometric identity. That is, secant square A minus tan square A is equal to 1. For all A, for which secant A and tan A are defined. Suppose, if I am taking A equals to 90 degrees, this is not true. Why don't we take A equals to 90 degrees? Because of, we are supposed to substitute the values of the A for which secant A and tan A are defined only, because of, according to the definition of the identity. Now, in triangle ABC, what is secant A? AC by AB. What is tan A? BC by AB. By Pythagoras theorem in triangle ABC, AC square is equal to AB square plus BC square. Now divide this equation with AB square. Then what do you get? AC square by AB square is equal to AB square by AB square plus BC square by AB square. What is AC by AB? AC by AB is equal to secant A. Therefore, this is AC by AB whole square. Therefore, secant square A. AC by AB value is secant square A is equal to AB square by AB square equals to 1 plus BC by AB is nothing but tan A. It's whole square. BC by AB whole square is nothing but tan square A. Now, secant square A minus tan square A is equal to 1. After that, we have to write definitely it is true for all the values of the A where secant A and tan A are defined. That's why this is the second identity of the trigonometry. Let us see the third trigonometric identity, that is cosecant square A minus cot square A is equal to 1 for all A where cosecant A and cot A are defined. Here also, we have to substitute a value such that cosecant and defined or not. If it is undefined for some values of the a, such type of a values need to be omitted. Now, in triangle ABC, what is cosecant a? AC by BC. And what is cot a? AB by BC. Now, by the Pythagoras theorem, we have one result, that is AC square equals to AB square plus BC square. Now, divide this equation with BC square. Then what do we get there? AC square by BC square equals to AB square by BC square plus BC square by BC square. Then what is AC by BC value? From 1, AC by BC is equal to cosecant A. Therefore, AC by BC whole square is there. Replace AC by BC with cosecant A, then it becomes cosecant square A. Is equal to, what is AB by BC from the 2? From 2, AB by BC is equal to cot A, which is equal to cot square A plus 1. BC square cancel, 1 is remaining. Therefore, finally, we got cosecant square A minus cot square A is equal to 1 for all A where cosecant A and cot A are defined. Children, we have completed the concepts of trigonometry. Let us see some examples related to this lesson. Children, see the first example. Express the ratios of cos A, tan A, secant A in terms of sin A. To establish the relation among all these trigonometric ratios, we need to have trigonometric identities. Let us see the solution. I am using the first identity, sin square A plus cos square A is equal to 1. Then what is cos square A? 1 minus sin square A. Make cos A as the subject, then what do you get? Plus or minus root over 1 minus sin square A. Now what is secant A? The next requirement is secant A. Secant A also need to express in terms of sin A. Secant A is equal to 1 by cos A, which is equal to plus or minus 1 by root over 1 minus sin square A, because of already we got the value of the cos A in terms of sin square A. Therefore, secant A is equal to plus or minus 1 by root over 1 minus sin square A. Now come to tan A. What is tan A? Tan A is nothing but sin A by cos A. Sin A already in terms of sines. Now cos A, already we knew that the cos A in terms of sines, plus or minus root over 1 minus sin square A. Replace cos A by plus or minus root over 1 minus sin square A. Finally, tan A is equal to plus or minus sin A by root over 1 minus sin square A. Let us see another example. Secant A into 1 minus sin A into secant A plus tan A is equal to 1. What is LHS? Secant A into 1 minus sin A into secant A plus tan A. First of all, we have to convert each and every trigonometric ratio in terms of sines and cos. Secant A. What is secant A in terms of cos? 1 by cos A. 1 minus sin A into. See, secant A is nothing but 1 by cos A plus tan A. How can we write tan A in terms of sines and cos? Sin A by cos A. Now, 1 by cos A into 1 minus sin A into. Take cos A as the LCM. Then what is the numerator? 1 plus sin A. We will get the numerator as 1 plus sin A. 1 plus sin A by cos A is equal to, now simplify it. Denominator cos A into cos A, cos square A is there. And in numerator, 1 minus sin A into 1 plus sin A is there. A minus B into A plus B is there. And A minus B into A plus B is, we have the formula A square minus B square, which is equal to 1 minus sin square A. Here A is equal to 1, B is equal to sin A. That's why A square minus B square is equal to 1 minus sin square A. Now use first trigonometric identity, that is sin square A plus cos square A is equal to 1. Now replace 1 with sin square a plus cos square a, then sin square a and sin square a get cancelled. Now we left with cos square a. Then cos square a by cos square a is nothing but 1. We proved LHS is equal to RHS. See another example. Prove that sin theta minus cos theta plus 1 by sin theta plus cos theta minus 1 is equal to 1 by secant theta minus tan theta. Using the identity, secant square theta minus tan square theta is equal to 1. Now, see, LHS is equal to sin theta minus cos theta plus 1 by sin theta plus cos theta minus 1. Now, divide the numerator and denominator with cos theta. Then it becomes as sin theta by cos theta is equal to tan theta minus cos theta by cos theta is equal to 1. Therefore, minus cos theta becomes as minus 1 plus 1 by cos theta is equal to secant theta. And how the denominator becomes? And if you divide sin theta plus cos theta minus 1 with cos theta, then sin theta by cos theta is equal to tan theta plus cos theta by cos theta is equal to 1 minus 1 by cos theta is equal to secant theta. Now, write tan theta plus secant theta minus 1 by tan theta minus secant theta plus 1. Now, I am going to replace this 1 with identity of secant square theta minus tan square theta equal to 1. Replace 1 by secant square theta minus tan square theta. Write the remaining in the same way and just replace 1 by secant square theta minus tan square theta. Then it is in the form of the a square minus b square. That's why secant square theta minus tan square theta can be written as a minus b into a plus b. Here a is the secant theta, b is the tan theta. Therefore, secant theta plus tan theta into secant theta minus tan theta. Again, children, observe. Here, I replace 1 by secant square theta minus tan square theta. Otherwise, there is another method also. Instead of replacing in numerator 1 with the secant square theta minus tan square theta, we can replace denominator also with the secant square theta minus tan square theta. Tan theta plus secant theta minus secant theta plus tan theta into secant theta minus tan theta. If you replace the numerator 1 with secant square theta minus tan square theta. Then what is common here and there? Tan theta plus secant theta is the first term, and this is also there in the second term, secant theta plus tan theta. Get common secant theta plus tan theta. What is remaining here? 1 is remaining. Minus of, here what is remaining? Secant theta minus tan theta is remaining. Multiply with minus, then what do you get? Minus secant theta, minus of minus, plus tan theta. Therefore, finally, what do you get? Secant theta plus tan theta into 1 minus secant theta plus tan theta by denominator is tan theta minus secant theta plus 1. These two are same. These two are cancelled. Then what is remaining? Secant theta plus tan theta is remaining. Again, replace. Actually, what need to prove there? 1 by secant theta minus tan theta need to prove. Therefore, replace its denominator by secant square theta minus tan square theta, which is equal to 1. Nothing is there means in denominator 1 is there. That 1 is replaced with the secant square theta minus tan square theta. Again, it is in the form of the a square minus b square, and use the formula a plus b into a minus b equals to a square minus b square. Then we can write this is as secant theta plus tan theta into secant theta minus tan theta. Secant theta plus tan theta in denominator and numerator get cancelled. Now what is remaining? 1 by secant theta minus tan theta, which is equal to RHS. Children, let us see another example. Sin a plus cosecant a whole square plus cos a plus secant a whole square is equal to 7 plus tan square a plus cot square a. Now, consider LHS. Sin a plus cosecant a whole square plus cos a plus secant a whole square. A plus b whole square. We know that a plus b whole square is a square plus b square plus 2ab. Using that formula, expand it. Then, sin square a plus cosecant square a plus 2 into sin a into cosecant a we will get. For the second term also, expand similarly, then we will get cos square a plus secant square a plus 2 into cos a into secant a. Then sin square a plus cos square a value is 1. And also sin a and cosecant a are reciprocal to each other. Therefore, sin a into cosecant a is equal to 1. Cos a and secant a is equal to 1. Those two are also reciprocal to each other. Then 1 plus 2 into sin a into cosecant a is nothing but 2. 2 into cos a into secant a is nothing but 2. Therefore, 1 plus 2 plus 2 plus cosecant square a plus and secant square a are remaining. Now use the identities of 2 and 3. Then secant square a is equal to 1 plus tan square a and cosecant square a is equal to 1 plus cot square a. Replace those two. Then we will get 1 plus 2 plus 2 is 5 and replace cosecant square a by 1 plus cot square a, replace secant square a by 1 plus tan square a. Finally, we got 7 plus tan square a plus cot square a, which is equal to RHS. Children, let us see another example. In triangle PQR, the angle Q is given 90 degrees and the relation between the two sides of the triangle is given as PR plus QR equals to 25 centimeters. Now PQ is equals to 5 centimeters. Find the values of sin P, cos P and tan P. Let us see the solution. In triangle PQR, angle Q is equals to 90 degrees and PQ is equals to 5 centimeters. And the relation between other two sides are given as PR plus QR is equal to 25 centimeters. Now apply Pythagoras theorem in this triangle PQR. PR square equals to PQ square plus QR square. PR can be replaced by 25 minus QR. Because of PR plus QR is given as 25 centimeters. Therefore, we can replace PR by 25 minus QR whole square is there. P 25 minus QR whole square is equal to, what is the value of the PQ? PQ equals to 5. 5 square plus QR square. Now, simplify it. Expand using the formula A minus B whole square. Then we will get 25 square, which is equal to 625 plus QR square minus 2 into 25 into QR is equal to 25 plus QR square. Now see, QR square cancelled. 625 minus 25 is equal to 600. Now transpose this to the right hand side, then it is equal to 50 into QR. Minus becomes plus. Therefore, 600 equals to 50 into QR. Now make QR as the subject. QR equals to 12 centimeters. If you get QR, automatically with the given result, we will get the PR value as 25 minus 12, which is equal to 13 centimeters. Now we got all three values of PQ, QR, and PR. What are actual requirements? Sin P, finding sin P. Sin P is equal to, this is P. Sin P is defined as the opposite side to P by hypotenuse. Here QR by PR will come for sin P. QR value is, now only we got as 12. Therefore QR equals to 12. Therefore sin P is equals to 12 by 13. Now come to the cos P. Cos P is nothing but the adjacent side to angle P by hypotenuse, that is PQ by PR, which is equal to 5 by 13. Tan P, the last requirement is finding of tan P. Tan P can be obtained using the formula of sin P by cos P. Otherwise, from the diagram, we will get as tan P is equal to QR by PQ, QR by PQ, which is equal to 12 by 5. Okay, children? Children, let us see this example. These two results we are going to prove. Cos A by 1 plus sin A plus 1 plus sin A by cos A is equals to 2 secant A. And the second result is tan theta by 1 minus cot theta plus cot theta by 1 minus tan theta is equal to 1 plus secant theta cosecant theta. Let us see the solution of the first result. Cos A by 1 plus sin A plus 1 plus sin A by cos A. Observe the RHS part of the first result, secant A, 2 secant A. That is nothing but 2 by cos A. So that second part, no need to change. In the LHS, the second term, no need to change. 1 plus sin A by cos A is there. So that, come to the first one, cos A by 1 plus sin A, multiply with 1 minus sin A, both numerator and denominator. Then what do you get? Cos A into 1 minus sin A by 1 plus sin A into 1 minus sin A. What is the advantage? Later we will see that one. Plus 1 plus sin A by cos A. Then after simplification, we get cos A into 1 minus sin A by 1 minus sin square A. What is 1 minus sin square A? From the first trigonometric identity, 1 minus sin square A is nothing but cos square A. That is the advantage to multiply with 1 minus sin A. If you concentrate on what need to prove, then automatically what need to do, automatically we know that. Now, cos A, 1 minus sin square is nothing but cos square A. 1 cos A is cancelled. Now, cos A is remaining. Now, take cos A is the LCM. Then what is remaining here? Already this cos A is cancelled. What is remaining here? 1 minus sin A, 1 minus sin A. Plus, what is remaining in the second term? 1 plus sin A. Both sin A cancel. Now, 1 plus 1 is equals to 2. 2 by cos A is equals to 2 secant A. The first result proved. Once again, here the first step be multiplied with 1 minus sin A. Because of to convert the denominator in terms of the cos, that is the advantage of multiplying with 1 minus sin A. After that, very easy, simplification only. We will get the, to get the result, simplification is required there. Now come to the second result. Tan theta by 1 minus cot theta plus cot theta by 1 minus tan theta. Now, what is the requirement here? What need to prove? 1 plus secant theta into cosecant theta. Secant theta into cosecant theta, that means if you express the total LHS part in terms of sines and cos, then at the end there is a chance to get in terms of secants and cosecants. So that tan theta, what is tan theta? Sin theta by cos theta. In terms of sine and cos, we have to express it, and cot theta also. 1 minus cos theta by sin theta. Plus cot theta is equals to cos theta by sin theta by 1 minus sin theta by cos theta. That means total tan thetas and cot thetas are expressed in terms of sin thetas and cos thetas using the formula of tan theta is equals to sin theta by cos theta, cot theta is equals to cos theta by sin theta. Now simplify it. Then what is the LCM here? Sin theta is the LCM. Then the denominator is sin theta minus cos theta by sin theta. By simplification, sin square theta by, already one sin theta is in numerator and in denominator one more sin theta is there. Therefore, it becomes a sin square theta by cos theta is remaining here. Sin square theta by cos theta into, by taking the sin theta as LCM, here we got sin theta minus cos theta. Plus, similar simplification is there for the next step also. Here cos theta is the LCM, then cos theta minus sin theta, we will get it. Now, cos square theta by sin theta into cos theta minus sin theta, we will get it. Now, what is the LCM of cos theta into sin theta minus cos theta and sin theta into cos theta minus sin theta? Now, take the LCM. Sin theta cos theta into sin theta minus cos theta is the LCM. Now, cos theta sin theta, cos theta into sin theta minus cos theta is also there. Therefore, numerator need to be multiplied with sin theta, then it becomes as sin cube theta. Here, sine theta into cos theta minus sine theta is there. Therefore, its numerator need to multiply with cos theta. Then it becomes as cos cube theta. Sine cube theta minus cos cube theta by sine theta cos theta into sine theta minus cos theta. Now, sine theta minus cos theta into, we have a formula of sine cube theta minus cos cube theta. What is that? A cube minus B cube. It is in the form of the A cube minus B cube. What is A cube minus B cube? A cube minus B cube equals to A minus B into A square plus B square plus AB. So that sine theta minus cos theta into sine square theta plus cos square theta plus sine theta into cos theta. Replace A by sine theta, B by cos theta. Then we have this expansion, sine theta minus cos theta into sine square theta plus cos square theta plus sine theta into cos theta. Now sine theta minus cos theta get cancelled here and there. In numerator and denominator, sine theta minus cos theta is there. These two are cancelled. Now what is remaining? We know that first, using first identity, this is equal to 1. 1 plus sine theta cos theta by, what is remaining in denominator? Sine theta cos theta is remaining. Therefore, finally, 1 plus sine theta cos theta by sine theta cos theta is remaining. Now, 1 by sine theta into cos theta is nothing but secant theta cosecant theta plus sine theta cos theta by sine theta cos theta is equal to 1. Therefore, finally, our result is secant theta cosecant theta plus 1. Is it clear, children? Okay. Thank you to all and all the best.